Hello, welcome back to VeggiePlot. Up on the allotment today, got a lovely harvest to do of the sweet corn. I think they're more or less ready, or perhaps they're even overripe. And some of them, it seems, that are beginning to be attacked by the little critters, which actually I'll cut to a little video now I shot at home because we had terrible attack of the corn I was growing in the garden. It's all been wiped out. I think rats, I think, unbelievable. Anyway, so yeah, I want to get all the sweet corn out. We're going to look at the courgettes, get some of them, and get some a cabbage or something like that as well. But yeah, there's an awful lot to do up here at the moment. Right, let's get on, harvest some of these, get all the socks off, and see what we've got on the sweet corn. Right, let's just see. Break a couple of these off, shall we, and see what we've got. As I say, there's always the potential that they've gone over. The leaves on the outer side are going a bit brown, and that doesn't look too bad actually. It looks okay, but one or two of them, yeah, see, you can see the sort of a milky substance around there, and they're going a bit brown in places, so I suspect that this is sort of on the turn. But anyway, we'll go through all the others, see how many we get, and yeah, tidy them up near the compost. Well, that's not too bad. Let's take them over to the composter and give them a clean up and see what we've actually got. Right, that is all of them. Yeah, not too bad. A good size, but just have to see if they're actually any good. That's got some okay bits in it. Right, anyway, enough of this. You don't want to see me do all these corn. I think I've got, you know, about 40 or so, 40, 50. So I'll get on and do these and we'll have a look at the end when they're all finished. Right, that's all of those done, all cleaned up and sorted out. I think we've got about 38 in total, with about two or three that might be a bit overripe. So I'll go home and check those out first, but yeah, quite pleased with the sweet corn harvest. Most, as I say, are, yeah, not bad, and we should just cut them off. Cut the kernels off and freeze them and so on, and dehydrate them. Hello, sorry about the short interlude here, but I'm not running any YouTube ads on this particular video. I'm going to try and sponsor it myself. So as you'll see in the background here, I have lots of different things which I've designed. I've been a designer, photographer, illustrator all my working life. And so this year I really wanted to illustrate and put together a calendar for allotmenters and vegetable and fruit growers. And so it's finally come back from the printer and it's here, and I really wanted to show it to you. So it's a really nice size, it's A3, so there's plenty of room inside to write your notes and your dates for birthdays and sewing dates, etc. It comes with a really tough metal hanging loop here, no sort of little hole that you see on many calendars where they just tear through. It comes with really thick paper as well, so it's really printed quite nicely. On every single page, there's a different page for every single month. It contains either a fruit or a vegetable illustration. They're all different colours. And then on each month also, you get the lunar cycle dates here. So if you like growing by the moon, or you find that interesting or useful, you'll find the lunar calendar dates here as well. So if I just quickly flick over to my website here, if you were to go here and click on the 2025 calendar, you'd be able to see all the details and all the images that relate to the pages and so on for each month. So we've got sort of parsnips, cauliflowers, we've got red cabbage, asparagus, some peas, etc., etc. But right at the back of the calendar, I've got two extra pages. I've got a sow and harvest guide, and this gives you 70 herbs and vegetables with the dates that you can sow the seeds, and obviously then you can harvest. And obviously you can transfer those dates through to the calendar to help you plan the crops that you might want to grow throughout the year. And then the last page is a what to do and when, and this has got hints and tips and tasks that you can be doing in your allotment, on your allotment or in your garden throughout the year. So if I just bring you back here, so I've got not an awful lot of these printed. I just wanted to see how it was going this year. So if you fancy picking yourself up one, or one for a friend, someone who's into their allotment, then it would be really, really appreciated. Okay, that's the sponsorship over. Let's get back to the video. Right, I've got those bagged up. I was just going to look at these Crown Prince squash. Look at that one. That's a beauty, isn't it? I don't know if that one's going to make it. This one definitely hasn't made it. And there's another one there. But one thing I quite like to do at this time of year with a Crown Prince, and well, any squash really, is to make sure that you've got, when they start to ripen like this, is to take off the leaves around them. And that is just to help them ripen a bit in the sun, let the sun get to them, but also to prevent sort of scratching which can form on the surface and damage them, and you know, could cause them to rot if they're not quite mature enough. So yeah, I just like to go through and take off the surrounding leaves. These will go on the compost, and then that basically leaves that one open to the elements, and then hopefully, you know, that'll get lots of sun and wind to dry it, and it won't succumb, you know, to slugs and things. And we'll have a lovely Crown Prince squash. So I shall just go through all of these, clean out the leaves that are covering them, and then just let the air and the light get to them. Yeah, just clear those leaves off, and they shouldn't damage them then. That's the plan anyway. And that's the thing, it's also at this stage, you know, this isn't going to do anything now. I don't think that one's going to ripen, it's being eaten. So what I'll do is cut this off, and then this can all go on the compost. It's not, no use to the plant now. I'll take the ends off this one. That's that. And that one. And I'll just leave that to ripen. Right. Sorry, throwing the camera around a bit there, wasn't I? But yeah, right, I'm just going to work through all of these, clear these all up. I've got another one in here. So I've got quite a few coming, and then hopefully another one there. I've got a few more on this bed too. So yeah, quite a good squash crop by the looks of it. Right, I do that, and then I think we'll get one of the cabbages, and then we'll head off home. Just thought I'd trim off the leek heads, so we might get some seeds on these. I shall hang them upside down to dry somewhere in a shed or something, but yeah, I think it's about time these came out. Certainly end up with a bit of rubbish, don't you? Anyway, let's get this on the compost. Well, I think that's all of that cleared up as much as I can, and I think we've got about 20 squash coming, so that's quite nice, which I really didn't expect. I thought that this year they were going to be a bit of a flop because I put them in a bit late, but I don't know if they'll all ripen up in time. Might be small, but some of them are nice, good size. So yeah, if we get 20 out of that, I'll be amazed. Right, let's get one of these cabbages. I've got quite a few in here still, and they're looking really, really healthy. So I think what I'm gonna do, I'll take that one there, or that one there perhaps, because it's looking really big and it needs harvesting. So where the best way to come in for that is, probably under here. Right, let's go under the netting if we can. Don't know if you can see through that. Cut that. Right, what have we got here? Oh, look at that. Isn't that beauty? Isn't that amazing? Fantastic looking cabbage. Right, let's just get these outer leaves off, give it a clean up, put it in the bag, and see what we've got. A couple of the leaves snapped off, but yeah, look at that. Get some idea of what size it is. Anyway, let's take these outer leaves off, put them in the compost, and see what we have. That beauty. I've never grown such great cabbages and cauliflowers. This year really has been really good for them. I don't know, it's the cold weather and lots of moisture maybe, but yep, certainly has been a good one for cabbages. I think this is a type of Savoy. I'll put their name on the screen if you're interested. But yeah, really pleased with that. Right, I was just going to head off, but actually I've just figured out I've got to go and look at these courgettes, because yet again, as you can see, courgettes turn your back and they get enormous. These are Soleil, an F1 courgette, and they've done really well this year. I had planted, sown about 12, but I only ended up with these five, as I've said before. But yeah, they've done all right, actually. This is getting a bit big, obviously, and I need to harvest the rest of them. But yeah, F1 Soleil, quite nice. I think you can grow this one upright, but I just haven't had the time to prune it, train it that way. So yeah, let's just take these off. Yeah, they're getting a bit big. I've been making courgette cake with these, which is really nice, with raspberries in, if you ever get a chance. But they don't seem to last that long in the fridge, it seems. So the sooner they're eaten, the better. And obviously these little ones with no seeds in are the best. Not a bad little haul. Got some little ones as well. But yeah, guess what also I found over by the pear tree on the ground? We have a windfall pear. There are a few more to come in here, which are... they're not really ripe yet at all, but yeah, we shall see. See if they ripen up. I can't believe I've actually got my first pear. So anyway, take this home, see if it ripens up. At some point, I've got to get on and prune this. It's well over the height of its, that it's allowed to be, but I'm just waiting for the weather to change a little bit, and then I shall come in and give it a prune. Anyway, a bit later on in the season, maybe. Right, let's get these courgettes and head home. Right, here we are in the greenhouse, and as you can see, I've got quite a lot of lovely spaghetti chilies coming. Look at these fantastic things. They're not sort of going ripe, all of them, yet. I've got a few here just beginning to go red, but yeah, look, they're dripping in spaghetti chilies.